Welcome children. Today I'm going to take your English as well as geography class. Let me first take your English class. Take out your English literature book Roots chapter 5, The Secret Pleasure of Reginald. Let me tell you the story in gist. Through this extract, the narrator wants to say that one Saturday afternoon the narrator found Reggie in the club, leaning in a long chair motionless with his eyes staring on the ceiling. When the narrator asked why he was not doing anything, he frowned a little and simply replied that it matters what he was not doing. The narrator heard it as phrase, but it was so little connected with Reggie that the narrator asked its meaning. Reggie shied and then asked if I knew Botfish and had I ever spent a weekend at Botfish place in the country. The narrator shuddered, saying that he knew Wilkinson Botfish and had spent a weekend there, but that week he was not going to spend a weekend there. When Reggie interrupted, at that time the narrator, instead of strolling to the Botfish garage, he was listening to the unimportant talk about his new car. The narrator looked at him and called Reggie an old man. Reggie told he was perfectly well and had asked the narrator if he could imagine anything more awful rather than to spend a weekend with Botfield. The narrator couldn't think of it at the right moment. Neither he was going to the house to listen Mrs. Botfield nor his son, Willie Botfield's premature intelligence. Reggie thanked the narrator for not being with Botfield. He further said that he had settled himself in the chair. Time passed and he had not met Mrs. Botfield. After dinner, he was going to have some happy time. Next Saturday, he was going to stay with his host Pringle. The narrator considered it as the greatest to be fit and happy. Reggie concluded that on Monday morning, he gets all energy and feels like a lion. The narrator too reasoned that he selected Botfish to have some real rest and sat in the chair beside Reggie. Reggie also assured the narrator to join him at Botfish to feel better. The narrator then closed his eyes and relaxed to have some peace. And with this, I am ending my today's English class. Now let me take your geography class. Chapter 4, Withering and Soil Formation, Types of Soil. Rock particles that get withered are classified into three types based on its size. The largest particles form sand, finer particles form silt, and finest particles form clay. The types of soil are determined by its proportion. The main types of soil are alluvial soil, red soil, laterite soil, black soil, and desert soil. Soil erosion. Soil erosion is the process of the removal of the top layer of soil on a large scale by rainwater, wind, or human activity. This is further accelerated by deforestation and overgrazing. Soil conservation. Essentially, this means the use of techniques which will protect the soil from the agents of erosion like wind and water. This also involves the application of methods which will add to the health of the soil and protect its natural qualities. Planting trees. Planting of trees to replace the ones which have been cut down, and also planting them in areas like edges of deserts and along coastal areas to curtail the spread of the desert and protect the land from the winds which blow at great speed. Trees are also planted along the banks of rivers to prevent the river from cutting into the adjoining land. Terrace farming. This is commonly practiced along the slopes of hills to prevent the topsoil from getting washed up. The water walks down the step instead of gushing down. This process also maximizes the use of available fertile land. Crop rotation. To prevent the depletion of soil's mineral strength, crops are rotated. For example, legumes are grown in between for nitrogen fixation. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.